Hi, this is Krista at TSY Afterparty. Today I want to give you a little update on the tortoise eggs. So this is the setup we have. I have a water bottle here. This is for the humidity, so it has like an automatic drip system. I just have this frame welded so I can put a bigger bottle here. And I cut off the lid, or the bottom, of one water bottle so I can just kind of tip fresh filtered water into it without having to disconnect it all the time. So I should have done that a long time ago. And that fits just like that. So I just have to pop that off, pour water in maybe once a week. The control panel, I'm keeping it, I had it about 30, now I have it at 31. Humidity 75, that has been 143 days. It goes up to 99. And I didn't get this unit right away for Marvin's first clutch, but his clutch has since been, they hatched. So we had two from Marvin's first batch that were viable and fertilized, and he has one, or she, I thought Marvin was a boy for 15 years. One is hatching from batch number two, so they're taking about 4 months. They're supposed to take 150 days. They're taking about 120 days in this, it's a chicken egg incubator, actually. I just took out all the rolling stuff because chicken eggs have to be turned and tortoise eggs don't. So this is batch number two, and there's our little guy starting to come out. That little egg. Cute, right? So that's how you know that he's hatching. So he stays in here. He'll get off out of his shell completely on his own, and then it's just a nice cozy place for him to be. These are the other viable eggs from batch two, or possibly viable, and I'll turn that down. That's an alarm saying it's too low, it's too cold. So I went through all of our eggs today, most of them. Just the ones that have been like a few months old. I'm using a neck light. And if you put the neck light right on the egg, see, I don't know. I'm gonna say that's fine. These are all, to me, I think they're fine. I don't see, they're not yellow or they're not white. I think they could be. These could all be viable. If not, I'm giving them. See, that one looks good, nice and dark, right? Now I'll show you what it looks like, a non-viable. But I only do this after a couple months. I give them a good try. So I'm gonna shut that again, lock it. Now down here, these are all non-viable. I don't know if you can see. Maybe we should go in the dark so you can see. See how it goes like bright yellow? And these are like 3 month old eggs. They're not fresh at all. They are from, I don't know, a long time ago. 4 months ago at least. Three and four months ago. So they are basically hollow. You can see, oh, that one you can see. See how you can like see straight through? If there was a tortoise in there, you wouldn't be able to see through because it would be a shell. See, like that one there. So yellow, white, or just basically empty after 3 months means not viable. Can I get that one to show you? There. So that's an empty egg after 3 months. If you're doing this right after your tortoise eggs hatch, they can look like this and it's still normal, so don't do this right away. I'm just making space in my incubator. But after 3 or 4 months, they should not be hollow. You should actually see something inside, like darkness at least. So these are not viable. I don't know what to do with them. I just took them out this morning, but I thought I'd give you a little setup. Oh, this is how I get my water from the sink, from my filter. I fill that one up, or at least halfway, and then I dump it into there, but I just keep it together so I know where it is. That's extra vermiculite and extra trays from these eggs here. It's cold now, so I don't think she's going to be digging anymore. And her last batch, I don't see any viable eggs in it at all. I can show you her last batch. Marvin laid 22 eggs about 3 weeks ago. But as of yet, they are not, I don't see them as being viable. You can see they're like hollow. I hope you can see. There's nothing in there yet. So I'm leaving them. That one might be something. So I think just a few eggs from each clutch. That one might be something. But I'm leaving them there for now. After a few months, if I can still see into them, I'm gonna say they're not viable. They take about 4 months to hatch. So if I need space, I'll check them. If they start smelling, I'll remove them. And if not, they'll just sit in there and we'll wait for tortoises. So that is where they're incubating. Party. Churchy's bed. Now here are Miss Peachy. Peachy's the big one and Pie is right at her face, I think. Or no, right behind her. Yeah, trying to bump her out of the way. So this is their little winter area where they hang out. This was full of skooma this morning. They've eaten it all, which is, I want to say Swiss chard. I'm not sure on that translation. Here's our two babies in here. So we do have a heat pad, under tank heat pad for them. But our tank is too small, so we're getting a tank made. So to keep it obscure, I printed grass from the internet on paper and taped it around the edge. And then these are our two babies so far. This hot water bottle just to keep it nice and warm in there. This is our first one. Come here, cutie. That's our first baby. This is Marvin's first offspring. Hi, baby Marv. So cute, right? So he's super active. They go out into the with the other leopard tortoises. You can see his underbelly. See, he's still a bit lumpy. Don't push me off. So he's still unfolding a little bit and smoothing out. So he hangs out in there. And then this one just hatched about a week. Now he's gonna try to eat something. That's too big for you, isn't it? Here, put it on the side. This little guy was just born about a week later. And his belly, that's where his egg sac was, his egg yolk. And she was really tiny. She's still really tiny. That's my big thumb right there. So they hang out in here. And then we have that other one that's hatching. We'll join them probably in about a week. It takes about 3 days for them to absorb their yolk and start like moving around. So when that little guy is ready, we'll bring her or him in here also. And this is just a little bit of a broken pot. They can hide underneath it if they feel like it. So far they're not interested. Oh look, she's gonna go in there now. Usually they just cuddle up right by the hot water bottle over on this side here, they park. But now maybe she's gonna go into it, that'd be nice. So we have a new tank coming. It's shorter, it's darker, and we can put the heat pad underneath it. For now, we just have them in here. Sometimes we put like a towel on one side to try to keep the heat in because it is really chilly. Well, yeah, look, she's going inside. I knew you'd love it eventually. Well, that's my incubator telling me it's too cold. So that is the setup for now and our new baby hatchling tank or area. It's not really a tank. Our area comes on Tuesday. So maybe next week I'll be showing you that one. So thanks for inviting me over and see you in the next video.